Hello creators, welcome back on the channel. Today, I like to share how to export edited video using KineMaster into a video file. After we finish editing a video, the last thing to do is to export it. Or usually we call this as the rendering process. Rendering is a process where we attach all the elements of the timeline into a video file. There are several things that we need to consider before exporting. They are the video resolutions, the bitrate, and the frame rate. These three things bring out the quality of the video.
The video resolution refers to the height of the video. Look at this example. We've got 540p, FHD 1080p, and so on. P stands for progressive scan, a way many screens display video. The bigger the number, the bigger the resolution. Next, we have the frame rate, which is the density of the video. For example, here's the 30fps or frame per second. It means there are 30 pictures in each second. Commonly, 25 or 30fps will be acceptable standard to get a smooth outcome. And then, we have the bitrate. This is the number bit per second. It sounds to show the quality of the size of a video. The bigger the number, the bigger size and the better quality you've got. Here's an example of a different resolution size. There are two ways to exporting a video. The first one, after we finish editing, we tap this icon on the left. And then, you will see video setting menu from the video that we want to export. The second way, we can get to the export menu from the main page. Let's say that we want to export a video some of the time. In the KineMaster application, we choose the project, then we choose the icon to get into the export menu. This way, we can export without opening the project. At the bottom, there is a number showing the size in the megabyte after we export it into a file. While under it, the available storage memory in our port. The button next to it is the one that we use to start the exporting process. The configuration shown here is usually adjusted to the phone performance and capacity. So by default, the option in the middle is the one suggested by KineMaster. So we can just hit export button without changing anything here. If we want to have a different size, let's say if we need lower resolution video or even higher, then we can adjust it this way. Press and select like this to reset the solution that we want. The same applies to the frame rate. While for bitrate, we can just slide it like this. As a reference, we can see this table which is recommended by YouTube. Many people usually use the default setting without changing anything. This time, I choose FHD resolution with 30fps for the frame rate. I suggest that you maximize the bitrate, but if you think it's too big, you can try to adjust it to 8 or 12 mega for decent result. Type this export icon and we start the exporting process. How long is the process? Well, it depends on the editing that we have made. The longer the duration, the longer the process is. Besides that, the setting that we apply and the phone specification also play an important role in the length of the process. The video outcome will be in MP4 format, a common format which can be played in many different video players. After finish with it, we'll have a video file. We can try to play it to see the result. For Android, the file will be stored in KineMaster folder that we can see in the default gallery. For iOS, it will be saved in the gallery that we can see from the photo application.
So, I guess that's all for now. Write your questions down below at the comment section. Thank you for watching. See you next time in the next video. Bye.